The filmmaker who caught this all on camera.
He's a journalist who has spent his career following extremist groups.
He is the founder and editor-in-chief for News to Share.
My name is Ford Fisher, and I run a news outlet called newstoshare.com. I've been running that actually since I was a student at American University. And basically what News to Share is about is I use raw footage and live stream to show a situation in a very raw and objective manner. So by live streaming, I show an event from beginning to end, and it creates a sort of reference point where when I put out a raw footage story where it has sort of no narration, very minimal editing, just kind of highlights from an event, people can see that and they can see the context of every single shot. I originally planned to do fiction film when I went to college, but I think that there are almost more important stories to be told when you get into real life. People have real grievances when they are willing to go out on the street to talk about what they care about. So I don't do a whole lot of video where I'm just sort of filming voters or interviewing random people on the streets, right? What I like to go to is the sorts of things that bring people out onto the streets to do protests or activism, because that's really where kind of the passion is, right? Someone has to really care about a cause enough to go out and kind of yell at a politician or a building in some cases, or in some cases use violence to express their grievance. This is the top of a flash grenade that was used on Inauguration Day. So 200 people were arrested there. Injuries are rather possible while in the middle of this stuff. So in order to get the best angle, the most close-up content that shows the sort of very details of what's going on, you really have to place yourself sort of in between both sides, right? If two people are fist fighting, you've got to be close to that. But then if you imagine that on a scale of 1,000 people versus 1,000 people, you kind of have to be on the front line in order to capture the content that you want. In Charlottesville, for example, I was maced twice, and on one occasion, one person threw another person, basically, and the second person had a flagpole, and the flagpole like went into my neck. In Providence, Rhode Island, I filmed a left wing versus right wing kind of fight, and Antifa poured a bottle of piss on a bunch of people, but it included me.
Antifa just sprayed like urine on everyone's faces. I feel like I'm gonna puke.
But I realized that by entering a situation where I know that the situation is necessarily likely to have violence, I can't then be upset when I myself become a victim of some amount of that violence. This mask I wore through the Baltimore riots, through Inauguration Day, and a lot of other situations. I think probably the most rewarding aspect of my work is that after I've covered something, when documentarians end up using it, it shows the actual value that the raw content has. Spike Lee's film, Black Klansman, the entire movie is showing racism from decades ago, but it's a lot of analogies to today. At the very end, it goes from a Ku Klux Klan cross-burning to Charlottesville, and so he's sort of solidifying the metaphor that he's making. And so a total of 3 shots of my footage are in that montage, but I actually worked a lot with his archival producer to help him find other sources and put it all together. The film did end up winning an Academy Award and a few Academy Award nominations as well. I sometimes like to joke that since my footage was approximately 1/10 of 1% of the movie, that I have 1/1000th of an Academy Award.